Welcome back to the channel. I'm Zuka the Flame Prince, back with another video. This is the 15th installment of my Eminem reaction series, and the four songs I'll be covering in this one are Crazy in Love, One Shot, Two Shot, Final Thoughts Skit, and then Encore. I think so far I have this as the best Eminem album I've listened to of the three that I've listened to. I hope that these last tracks, I don't think I know any of them off title alone, so I do hope that they can keep up the momentum, because part four, which is the one that dropped prior to this, I think that's the best collection of Eminem songs I've heard in a minute, as far as this reaction series is concerned. But anyway, without any further ado, let's jump right in. This is track 17, Crazy in Love. Bars, the way he builds up tension and then it starts again, I keep on expecting the hook to drop and then it just starts another four bars. I was gonna say, I've never heard Crazy in Love before, and I'm a minute and a half in, and I can see why.
Eyes always pulling devices out your personal vibrators and dildos. You fuck yourself so much you barely feel those anymore. You're only 24, but you're plenty more. Step out of line, even though I stay in your business, you've always kept out of mind. I wonder what's on your mind. Sometimes they say love is blind. Maybe that's why the first time I doubted your eye, you ain't see the sign. Oh, maybe you did, maybe you like being strong. Maybe cause we're crazy in love.
I don't know, I feel like maybe I may have heard either that sample or whatever original song that was. Nah, if I knew, I'd probably know the name. But yeah, this is definitely following up from Mockingbird. Would have been hard for any song, but this is not it. This is not it.
Penis to my pad, the moral, the very fiber, the whole substance to my rap. You are my reason for being, the meaning of my existence. If it wasn't for you, I would never be able to spit this sentence. I do in the irony is you rely. To inspire me like you do, you provide me the lighter fluid, the fuel to my fire, you're my entire supply, gas, the match and ignite it. The only way that I'm able to stay so stable is you're the legs to my table. If you were to break, I'd fall on my face, but I'm always gonna make you feel I don't need you as much as I really need you, so you don't use it to your advantage. But you're essential to me, you're the air I breathe. I believe if you ever leave me, I probably had no reason to be. You are the Kim to my Marshall, you're the Slim to my Shady, the trade of my Eminem.
Alright, okay. So did Eminem just adopt a daughter? He just said the Elaine to my Haley. So I'm gonna assume that's Haley's childhood friend, but I don't know what relation she has to Marshall, if it's his niece, an adopted daughter or what. Because he keeps on speaking about daughters in plural.
You like the pillar that props me up, the beam that supports me, the bitch who never took half, the wife who never divorced me. You like the roots of my evil, you let my devil come at me, you let me beat this shit out you before you beat this shit out me. And no matter how much, too much is never enough. Maybe because we're crazy in love.
No matter how much, too much is never enough. Because we're crazy in love. But this can't be. Is this for Kim? I don't know who the song is for. I thought it was for Kim because he said you're the Kim to my Marshall or whatever I said. But if he says the wife who never divorced me, I think Kim divorced him, which is why they had a custody battle to begin with. Otherwise, I'm confused on who the song is addressing. Because of his several times saying touch my body throughout the album, I thought possibly it's Mariah, but I don't know. I don't need to belabor the point though. I already said that this is a big letdown following the streak that led up to Marking Grant. But the next track is gonna be a posse cut, one shot, two shot featuring D12. I don't know who this is. This is the guy who killed himself at the end of When the Music Stops, Joe. Trying to think. Was there a posse cut in the Marshall Mathers LP? Trying to think if there's something else to compare this to aside from When the Music Stops, or if it's just those two. Niggas running, people shot all over the floor, and I'm trying to make it to the Andrew store. Dr. Sound of the Glock, even DJ House, you fucked around and got shot. I done messed around and forgot my tech. I don't see nobody but 5'5 and next. Can I be right? These niggas is tripping. I'm trying to slip through the exit and get to where my car is at. Bitches screaming everywhere, and 2 minutes ago, we was all joking and smiling. This chick is clinging on to me, sobbing and sighing. Said she didn't mean to diss me earlier, and she crying. But it's real, and it's on, and cats is getting killed. So I hugged her and used her body as a human shield. She got hit, now she's yelling. I told her, be right back, and the dumb bitch believed me. I squeezed through the back door and made my escape. I ran and got my 38, I hope it's not too late. So the scenario is there's a shootout going on at a club. I just scrolled down the list. Someone put the list of artists. So that person with the deep voice is titled Bizarre. The person who just left the bitch and she believed him is Conniver. Then afterwards will be Swifty McVeigh, then Eminem, and then Con Artist. That's the order of the rappers.
I'm on 7 Mile. What the fuck was that? Damn, somebody hit me from the back. With a gat, nigga, and my tie flat. And I just hit a pole. Them niggas some hoes.
Did you hit?
I don't know, but I can tell you what they drove. It was a black Mitsubishi with.
Man,
when I was on my way there, believe me, I'm leaving a caucus today. And I'ma park my car and walk the rest of the way. I'm in the mood to strut. My AK ain't even tucked. I'ma meet you at the club. Go fuck these hoes up.
One shot, two shot, three shots, four shots. All I hear is gunshots. This is where the fun stops. Body drop, hit the floor. Music's off, 20 stops. Everybody at the door. Somebody's licking shots.
I've never seen no shit like this in my life before. People are still camped out from the night before. Sleeping outside the door, waiting in line. Still trying to get inside the club. The CD12 perform. The fire marshals know the venue's too small. People are wall to wall. 3,000 and some
other. Eminem is just such a better rapper than the rest of D12.
Fans of some come wide from out the parking lot. Gets in an argument over a parking spot. Decides to pull his gun out and lets a few of them off. Mr. He's aiming for 6 feet away from the door in St. Andrew's Hall. Now the strays flying all over the place. Raise one bitch in the face. Another one of them came through the wall before anyone could even hear the first shot go off. I'm posted up at the bar having a mile too tall. Bullet whizzed right by my ear. Damn near shot it off. Thank God I'm alive. I gotta find a 9 and where the fuck is Vaughn. He usually tucks one on him. Wait a minute, I think I just saw Bizarre. No, I guess not. What the fuck? Oh my God, it was. I never saw him run so fast in my life. Look at him,
shots. All I hear is gunshots. This is
what fun stops. Body drop. Eminem's verse unified the scene. Everyone else, I don't know if this was intentional, and then once they had their verses, he decided to fill in the blanks. But you can see Bizarre, for example, leaving his wife on the floor and running out for the gun. I thought that was a conniver. Regardless, everyone said, gave their parts of the story, and Eminem is the one who can see all of them during their respective parts of their verses. This is a pretty cinematic track. I appreciate that about it. Beyond that, this is one of those that just don't do it for me. It's not like a horrible track. I'm just not a fan of the content, I guess.
Slow music, soft party stops. Everybody at the door, somebody's taking shots.
Friday night, came to this bitch right. Big ass on my left hand, there's an eagle in my right. I ain't come in this bitch to party, I came in this bitch to fight. Although I can't say here to fight, cause I'm popping nigga tonight. That's right, bitches, I'm drunk with revenge. Shot a box on the neck for trying to check when I get in. Foot told me to meet him here, so it's clear to the smuck. The shot off the back of the truck is up in this motherfucker. One shot for the money, two is to stop the show.
Alright, not much more I want to say on that track. It was okay. Eminem again, best rapping out of D12. Gonna go into the next track now. This is the final thought skit. Surprised he hasn't said anything about cannabis this time around. Oh shit! I know this song.
We came here to set this party off right. Let's bounce tonight. And if they don't let us in through the front, we'll come through the side. Cause I don't ever wanna lead a game without at least saying goodbye. So all the people on the left, all the people on the right, swing one last time.
This is just a nostalgic smile on my face. My brothers were the biggest fans of 50 Cent and G-Units growing up, so I've definitely heard the song.
Can't even find you. We stay on the grind. You slip, we outgrind you. You walk around mad, you let your anger blind you. We walk around just playing the violin behind you. And up with all the pissing and moaning, whining and bitching. Sit and observe, listen, you'll learn if you pay attention. Why I send more platinum albums later, three diamond worldwide. We're on the charts with a bullet and still climbing. We came here to set this party off right. Let's bounce tonight. And if they don't let us in through the front, we'll come through.
I don't know, I should probably go back and try and break down what I can from that verse. I'm just currently elated to hear the song again. It's been a minute.
I don't gotta promote it, but you would've known the doc is off the benches.
We keep the party rocking off the hinges. We ain't showing off, we're just going on popular consensus.
But critics say the doc is soft, doc is tough, doc is all washed up. Knock it off, who the fuck is doc impressing? Doc is this, doc is that, you got the wrong impression. You must be on the cock and doc is not the floor guessing. So DJ, take the needle and just drop it on the record.
What?
We gon' have this motherfucker hopping in a second. That's why we always say the best cut ass to make you scratch.
You see the swam with the sharks, wrestle with alligators. Spoke to a generation of angry teenagers. Whom if it wasn't for rap, the bridge the gap may be raised to be raised. May have never got the same
valid, fucking valid.
Stone pages, broke down buried.
Talk that shit, Eminem. Talk your shit.
Spoke to a generation of angry teenagers who moved it once and forever to bridge the gap, maybe raised to be racist. Who may have never got to see our faces, waste the cover of rolling stone pages, broke down barriers of language and races. Just call on a cape crusaders and leave it to me and trade it. Pass the mic to me and play the back and forth all day like the hot potato game is why we cater. We came here to set this party off right. Let's bounce.
Fucking hell. Great. Greatest outro to an Eminem album. One of the greatest outros I think I've heard. I never knew where this was in the track list, but this is crazy.
So all the people on the left, all the people on the right, say one last time.
Now, hands up, you know how we do. We make the club jump everywhere we go. It's no secret, everybody knows. The drinks involved, there's plenty of money involved. Plenty of honey's involved, the sunny Sundays and palm trees, Cali. Every day is just another party from the valleys, all the way to the 8 mile alleys.
Let's rally, hands up for the grand finale. Now Ray's about to see, Dre's about to speak. Blaze a pound of weed, 6 days about to week.
You could catch me in the studio banging out the beach to provide you with the heat to keep blazing out the speaker.
That transition where Eminem started rapping when Dre started talking about Detroit, I think that gives me an idea of how they did the reference for Dre to rap.
The Along with your unit records, persists the ritual. So never say never, cause Shady had the man together. Along with your unit records, persists the return of the Da-Doc. No one can do it better. We tear the club up and leave without a shred of evidence at all.
We came here to set this party off right. Let's bounce tonight. And if they don't let us in through the front, we'll come through the side. Cause I don't ever want to leave a game without at least saying goodbye. So all the people on the left, all the people on the right, scream one last time.
Encore. Yeah, I'm more than ready to stick my neck out. This album is better than the Eminem show overall, and is better than the Marshall Mathers LP by a long shot overall. Again, definitely of the three, the best production for the most part is also on this one. And I think more than any other one, my opinions on it are most boosted by nostalgia. I think I'll give that caveat to my take, but wow. What an album. What a fucking album. I think I could do without the skits. I could do without Puke in my first single. But other than that, most of these songs are solid. I don't get this part, but I think I've heard Eminem reference something, maybe calling back to this, about a shooting at a show. I don't know if he was calling back to this or if this is an actual incident that happened where the person came on stage and shot the audience. Unsure.
Bye-bye!
And then killed himself. I know there's obviously, what, 3 bonus tracks. I'm not going to do those. I'm sticking to the original albums as they came out. But yeah, that was the 15th part of my Eminem reaction. Damn, definitely finished strong. Crazy in Love, One Shot, Two Shot, could have come in earlier. If we had just losing us like that, spend some time working bread, then Final Thoughts skit, and then Encore. That would have been one of the best closings I think I've heard in an album. This is a solid album. Should I do an, I don't know if I want to do an impromptu grading, but if I had to pick S tier songs on here, Encore is S tier, Mockingbird is S tier, Like Toy Soldiers is S tier as well. Yellow Brick Road and Mosh aren't S tier, but they're like borderline. So if they had to be like A plus songs, it'd be Yellow Brick Road, Mosh. Yeah, I think that would be it. But yeah, I think I've outlined which songs I think were like the standouts on this project. I'm going to leave it at that. I've been Zuko the Flame Prince. If you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and smash the like button, smash the subscribe button, and share this video with other fans of Eminem you may know. But without it the way, I'm going to see you guys in the next video. Peace.